हेलो एवरीवन, सो दिस इज़ आवर सेकेंड वीडियो ऑफ द चैप्टर इलेक्टोरल पॉलिटिक्स. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू अंडरस्टैंड द टॉपिक और यू कैन से द कंसेप्ट ऑफ इलेक्शंस इन आवर कंट्री. नाउ द फर्स्ट थिंग इज़ वेरी क्लियर ओवर हियर दैट इन आवर कंट्री वी आर हैविंग अ पार्लियामेंट एंड इन पार्लियामेंट वी आर हैविंग अ टू बॉडीज, दैट मीन्स द लोकसभा एंड द विधानसभा. And after every 5 years, we are conducting an elections so that we can able to have our fresh and the new representatives according to the will of a people. If in case people are not satisfied with the current representatives, so after 5 years, we are having a chance to change those representatives. We are having a two type of elections in our country. The first is our general elections and the other one is our by elections. In the general elections, after every 5 years, we are having a chance to vote or to change our representatives with the help of voting only. But in the by elections, it is generally happened when the case of death or the resignation of any member took place. If any representatives occurred with a death or having a resignation, only in that situation, in mid of the 5 years, we are conducting a new elections, which is known as our by elections. Now, when the elections took place, so it basically take place in the constituencies, in the different constituencies. We are having a proper criteria. I'm not going to explain you all the electoral constituencies with the help of the bookish language. I'm just going to show you a chart. A rough chart you can able to see or understand what are the exact criteria of elections in our country. Now suppose we are going to elect the member of parliament. So here we are having India. And India is basically divided into a different constituencies, which is known as our electoral constituencies. Out of all these constituencies, we have to elect a single representative, and the person who will get majority of the votes or jiske pas majority of the seats hongi, that particular person is considered as our representatives. From every electoral constituencies, we will have one representatives, and these electoral representatives are known as our members of parliament. Currently, we are having 543 constituencies. Clear? So this is the system of our members of our parliament or how we are going to elect the MPs of our country. The next, somehow it is on the whole country level. But now if we come on the state level, suppose if I take the example of a UP. In from particular state, we are having the assembly constituencies. From the different constituencies we are having. And from each constituencies, we are having a different elected members, and these elected representatives are known as our MLAs. MLAs means members of legislative assembly. Clear? So here you can able to see how we are going to elect the members of parliament. Whole country mein se elected consequences hamare paas aaye. Out of these electoral constituencies, one representatives we are going to elect, and all these representatives are known as our members of parliament. If we talk about the MLAs, members of legislative assemblies, we are having a particular state. Us state mein se humne different assembly constituencies frame hui hamari, and from each constituencies we are having a different members. So all these members are known as our MLAs. Central government, state government. Now next come on the local level. Now at the local level, we are having a village or a town. Basically first town, then villages. From the now the towns and villages are divided into a different wards. Okay, and all these wards we are having a different members. In wards mein se mere paas kya hua, alag alag members aaye. और हर एक वार्ड का हमारे पास लोग वोट करेंगे. सो वी आर हैविंग द म्यूनिसिपैलिटीज़. फिर म्यूनिसिपैलिटीज़ के बाद अगर गांव में है, विलेजेस में है, देन वी आर हैविंग द पंचायती राज सिस्टम ओवर देयर. ठीक है? सो इस तरीके से हमारे पास हमारी पूरी कंट्री डिफरेंट इलेक्टोरल कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसीज में, देन असेंबली कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसीज में, देन हमारे पास डिफरेंट वार्ड्स में डिवाइडेड है, जिसके अकॉर्डिंगली हमारे पास यहाँ पे वोटिंग करके हम लोग अलग अलग लेवल के रिप्रेजेंटेटिव्स को चूज करते हैं सो दैट दे कैन एबल टू टेक अ डिसीजन फॉर आर वेलफेयर ओनली. क्लियर? सो दिस इज अ स्मॉल सिस्टम ऑफ आर इंडिया, ऑफ आर इलेक्शन सिस्टम ऑफ आर इंडिया. सो फ्रॉम हेयर, फ्रॉम दिस टू वी हैव टू गो थ्रू विद दीज थिंग्स, दीज पैराग्राफ्स. नेक्स्ट वी आर हैविंग till that paragraph you can able to see that how we are having this, what are the systems of elections in our India. The next we are having is the reserved constituencies. Now the word reserve means humne unke liye koi cheez reserve kar li hai. As you know very well that India is having a very diverse kind of people, consists of diverse kind of people, caste system, all these things. Clear? So in our India we are having the different people like SCs and STs, you can see over here, scheduled caste and scheduled tribes. In our political system we are having a reserved seats for scheduled caste and the scheduled tribes. They are the minorities, or you can say that weaker section of the society. In log ka exploitation na ho, isliye constitution ne inke liye proper reserved seats rakhi hain. Currently we are having 84 seats of SCs and 47 seats of STs in our Lok Sabha. और इन सीट्स पे सिर्फ इन SCs और STs का ही रोल प्ले है, इनके अलावा कोई और इन सीट्स को ऑक्यूपाई नहीं कर सकता. इफ़ इन केस नो SC और नो STs आर देयर, सो वो सीट्स हमारे पास वैकेंट रहेंगी, बट उन पर कोई भी हमारे पास ऑक्यूपाई उन्हें नहीं करेगा. क्लियर? सो इन दिस वे वी आर हैविंग द रिजर्व सिस्टम ऑफ आर रिजर्व कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसीज इन आर MPs, for our MPs and for our MLAs as well. But apart from the Lok Sabha, we are having some reserved seats at the local level, that means at municipalities level and the panchayat level, so that other backward classes can also able to reserve their seats, as well as 1/3 of the seats are reserved for the women as well in our constituencies. So that women can also have a proper equal rights to stand in a votings or to take place in the politics of our country. Clear? The next we are having is the voters list. Now, election system पढ़ लिया, अब वोट कौन देने वाला है ये भी तो हमें पता होना चाहिए ना. But this thing is very clear to in our mind that in India we are following the universal adult franchise, which means that all the people of the age of 18 years or above are liable to cast a vote in our country, in spite of they are not focusing on the property, they are not focusing on the color, gender, caste or their education criteria. What the criteria is we are having is the person should be of the age of 18 years or above, regardless his or her gender, caste, color, anything. No one is going to focus on all these things. So all those people who are just liable to cast a vote, a list was prepared, ek list banegi aur usme un sab ka address with their ward numbers ki unhone kis vote ke accordingly wahan pe kahan pe jaake vote karna hai, all these things will be mentioned in that particular list, which is known as our voters list. And this is a very common topic, I think you guys know very well about the voters list. If any person is having some kind of criminals or criminal cases, or the person with an unsound mind, only in that situation that particular person is denied from a right to vote. And but this is a very rare situation, because when voters list banti hai to list us list mein particular candidate ka name, address, all these things are mentioned. Ab list banani, after every 5 years we have a new fresh list, because in these 5 years we are having some people जो 18 ईयर्स में आ गए हैं, वी आर हैविंग द पीपल जिनकी डेथ हो गई है, तो उन सब के नाम हटाकर इनको एक नया नेम्स देने, नई लिस्ट बनाना इज द मैंडेटरी टास्क. नाउ आफ्टर द लिस्ट इज प्रिपेयर, देन वी आर हैविंग द इलेक्शन फोटो आईडी कार्ड, दैट मीन्स EPIC आइडेंटिटी कार्ड ओवर हियर. दैट मीन्स जो हमारे वोटर आईडी कार्ड होते हैं ऑल, वो बनते हैं हमारे पास यहाँ पे, सो दैट एवरी पर्सन मस्ट कैरी देयर वोटर आईडी विद देम and the name should be mentioned in the voter list, ताकि कुछ भी biasness में हमारे पास काम ना हो. So in this way we are having the right, the criteria of voting which is followed in our country. Earlier the voting card वोटर आई डी कार्ड वॉज कम्पल्सरी बट नाउ वी आर हैविंग आधार कार्ड, वी आर हैविंग द ड्राइविंग लाइसेंस, राशन कार्ड. सो इन सब चीज़ों से हम शो कर सकते हैं कि या वी आर द मेम्बर और हम लोग इस पर्टिकुलर एरिया में रह रहे हैं. इट मीन्स वी मस्ट हैव आर आई डी प्रूफ विद अस टू कास्ट अ वोट फॉर अ रिप्रेजेंटेटिव्स. क्लियर? दैट्स ऑल फॉर दिस वीडियो. गो थ्रू विद द टॉपिक. इफ एनी डाउट देन यू गाइज कैन आस्क फ्रॉम मी. टिल देन टेक केयर एंड बाय बाय.